Hey, it's Dr. here with Better Life Research Tips. In this video, I will show you a simple model that can help us to develop a research proposal. This model requires us to generate an outline of our research proposal, all in one page, with four paragraphs that link to each other. These four paragraphs highlight the key elements of a research proposal. If we are able to develop a one-page outline of our research proposal using this model, the rest of our research activities would be much easier. A research proposal usually takes the form of persuasion. First, we need to convince our readers that we have a good idea. Second, we need to convince them that we have a feasible plan to realize that idea, and we are ready to go. So, in a four-paragraph model, we use the first paragraph to convince our readers that we have a good idea. And then we use the second paragraph to provide an idea of solution, and the third paragraph to show our commitment to the process of the solution, providing evidences that we are ready to go. And in the last paragraph, we reinforce that our idea is good by emphasizing the benefit of the study. So the whole logic follows the general pattern of problem, solution, and benefit. The first paragraph presents the problem. The second and third paragraphs provide the solution, and the last paragraph emphasize the benefit. The primary purpose of the first paragraph is to convince our readers that there is a specific critical need we need to address in order to solve a well-recognized problem. The key is to provide a convincing argument for that critical need. In the first paragraph, although we usually follow the pattern of from general to specific, we do not want to be too general in the first sentence, because the target reader of a research proposal are usually experts and professionals in the field, and they usually already have most of the background knowledge. Our first sentence should be a hook sentence that can immediately draw attention from an expert, and therefore it should be specific enough. It should clearly present a problem that is well recognized by the research community, and it should describe that problem in a way that will allow the readers to quickly connect the problem to the critical need that is identified by us. Therefore, we do not want to bore our readers or delay their understanding by iterating common background knowledge that everybody knows. Following the first sentence, we should try to use 3 to 4 sentences to summarize important known and unknown related to the problem, to inform our readers everything they need to know to understand the critical need. We'd better demonstrate that we are knowledgeable on the topic using only 3 to 4 sentences. But the most important thing is these 3 to 4 sentences should provide a logical point of view on the topic. They must lead to a conclusion that there is a critical need we need to address in order to solve the problem that is presented in the first sentence. The last sentence of the first paragraph is the heart of the whole research proposal, because it is the concluding sentence that clearly identifies the critical need, and the whole proposal is based on that critical need. The purpose of the second paragraph is to convince our readers that we have the solution to address the critical need that is identified in the first paragraph. The whole set of the solution may include the long-term goal, the objectives of the proposed study, and the optional central hypotheses, from broad to narrow. The long-term goal is the broadest. It projects the continuing of our professional activities beyond the proposed study. But it'd be nice if we can describe our long-term goal in a way that match the mission of the funding agency. The objectives of the proposed study are more focused, and they should match the critical need that is identified in the first paragraph. And we should provide a rationale that explains how do the objectives lead to the long-term goal. The central hypothesis is most narrow. It is a proposed explanation that needs to be tested. It can be used to serve the objectives, and it is optional. The key of the whole second paragraph is that we should provide a strong rationale that justifies the objectives. Explaining why and how the objectives can serve the critical need and contribute to the long-term goal. These justifications may be optional in the final research paper, but they are essential in a research proposal. In the third paragraph, we spell out the approach to realize the objective defined in the second paragraph. We may list specific tasks, and each task should serve one of the objectives. It would be nice to avoid the feasibility of one task be dependent upon the outcome of other tasks. That would make our plan more robust. Sometimes we may need to identify potential challenges or pitfalls and make contingency plan accordingly. The key of the third paragraph is to demonstrate that we are reliable and well organized. Not only we have a good idea which has been presented in the first paragraph, but also we have a feasible plan to realize that good idea. Lack of detailed actionable plan may be the number one reason that a proposal is declined. In the last paragraph, we reinforce that our idea is good by emphasizing the benefit of the proposed study. We should be explicit about how the expected outcomes will address the identified critical need and how the expected contributions will match the mission of the funding agency. Sometimes we may have to paraphrase the same idea we have used to describe the significance of the study in the first and the second paragraphs. But we'd better say it in diverse angle. It would be nice if we are able to provide examples on various ways in which our study would contribute. What are the possible outcomes of the study? What will become possible after the study is completed? The key of the last paragraph is to inform the funding agency both the certainty and the possibilities on the return of their investment. So, this is the one-page and four-paragraph model that can help us to prepare a research proposal. This one-page outline of a research proposal would be very useful, both for communication with cooperators or program directors in the funding agency, but also for ourselves during the process of proposal preparation. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Liu with Research Tips for the Underdogs. Writing research proposal is a key skill that is needed for a research career. Until next time, let's keep practicing to obtain more support for our research life.